This on. Hi, I'm Maeve. This is Strong. Thanks for being here. I totally appreciate all your support. See, I'm going to keep this. I'm not going to cut this off. But I appreciate your feedback on modalities that you want to see, times that you want to see in case you're not here live, but you normally take my class live. So things are shifting as we shift, and we'll just grow together and do all that good stuff. But right now, we're going to start. So let me get my music going. Let me share it with you. That's the most important detail. Let me get a teeny tiny more volume. Okay. All right. So today we're going to really focus on like form and classics. It doesn't mean we're not going to do some snazzy little jobbies, but really focusing on our quality of movement here. So nice and easy, just squatting it out, drop it down. And I just did exactly what I was about to cue not to do. Keep your whole foot rooted, don't lift the toes. Weight goes back toward the hips, but your feet are balanced here. So that you really feel like you're on your center and that you're not gonna fall backwards at all. I'm gonna give you a little side view right here. Whole foot rooted. Good. All we're gonna do is slow it down so that you can really feel it. We're gonna go down for two. And then back up for two. And in that slower sort of rhythm, maybe you get a deeper range of motion. And every time I say maybe, I really mean that. That's not like a teaser. It's like a maybe you do, maybe you don't. And then notice the balance in the feet. So when I start to get a little deeper after years of this habit of getting all my weight in my heels, it's harder for me to keep my toes down. Just be aware of the feet and that balance, inner, outer foot, front, back foot. You've got a couple more right here. On this down part, there's a little scoop of the belly back. Yes. Last one right here. Beautiful. Take one foot back. Drop. Not crazy long in the stance. Yes. Beautiful. So think of this as a split stance squat. Front in that heavy foot. That hip is catching the same way it would in a squat. And then it's like you have a kickstand to help you out. Because of this back leg in kind of a kickstand position, we oftentimes can go deeper than we can in a squat. But that, again, may not necessarily be true. We're gonna hold it down. We're gonna pulse it down right here. Hold and pulse. Right here. Yes, yes. Good. Last four, three, two, come through center, wide squat, drop. Weight is still balanced. Chest is up high. Beautiful. Really, really nice. Yes, yes. We're gonna take it over to the other side. We're gonna do that split stance squat. Drop down. Don't be afraid to play with your feet position, meaning length and width. When you drop, the front hip or the hip of the front leg is catching you and driving you up. When you come up, squeeze the back glute. Squeeze. We're gonna take it down. We're gonna pulse. Pulse. Keep it going, keep it going. Keep this booty squeezing. What I do. Mm-hmm. For four, three, we're gonna bring it back to the center, that big wide squat. Take it down. Beautiful. Good, bring your hands behind your head, elbows wide. We're gonna start to add some rotation into our repertoire. When we rotate, it's not just about bringing that elbow around, it's about bringing the torso around, the shoulder, the rib cage. Looks like this. Drop, cross. Yes. Hold it down, pull, keep the arms up. For four, three, two, hold it down. We're gonna take a side bend, over, over. So we're warming up the spine. We did some rotation. Now we're taking some flexion side to side. Lateral bending, if you will. A little deeper in the squat, four more, let's go. Four, three, two. We're gonna bring it around to a plank. All right, knees are always welcome. Squeeze your butt belly in. If knees are up, rise up, but take your tailbone for your heels. Squeeze your butt, push the ground away. And then down dog. I get done with one and move right on to another bitch. Shift back into plank. Yeah. Right leg up. So right when this right leg comes up, notice if the belly sagged and the back arched, hold neutral. Breathe, hold it, hold it. Little pulse, little pulse. Yes, that leg is long. Your opposite knee can be down. Most girls wanna hide the fact that the thrill yes, they yes. Chasing. Four, three, two, down dog, keep that right leg up, or that leg up, whichever one it was. I don't know if I actually specified which one. Bring your foot down, shift into plank. Belly in, lift that leg up. Other one. I don't know if I said which side, but for me it's left. Whichever one you have yet to do. Trying different drugs and girls. Again. For four, three, keep that leg up, lift it up and back. Bring your foot down. Walk your hands and your feet together. All the way up. Beautiful. One weight. One weight. All right, I'm going heavy. You'll decide. This is what it's gonna look like. Down, power up. You've done this leg movement. We're just putting some arm action to it, which means we have a little more core to control. Again. All this money, darling, what else is left to do? Smoke and enjoy my presence. Come on, come on. For four. Three. You're gonna keep your legs. We're just gonna hinge over. Good. Straight line from your back heel through your head. I'm bracing on my thigh with the opposite arm to get a sense of planking. Pull. So body is in plank. If you ignored this front leg, you're in plank. Both hips working like crazy. Press that front foot down. Back glute squeezes. Again, again for eight. Last four, three, two. Come through center. I swear we'll do the other side. You've done this movement. Hold the weight in front of you. Hug your elbows into your sides. Drop.
That's what it is.
Roll your shoulders open. Keep your chest lifted. And I'm addicted to champagne. half the songs I play, you have to just listen to the melody. Don't listen to the ridiculous lyrics. Yeah, like that one. There's a great little TikTok circulating. I'm not on TikTok. I don't need anything else. But I saw it on Instagram. And it's an instructor. She's teaching like a tread class. Last one. Perfect. Flip it around. And it's entitled, When You Regret Not Playing the Clean Version. And she's running on the treadmill all of a sudden. It's like this and that and this and that. And I'm like, me all the time. But half the time, there's no clean version. So I want to hear the song. And it doesn't come clean. I'm a steak in the game until I fall out. First I lean, grab a ball, and then I pop with it. Pop with it. When they bring the mic, the crowd, I rock with it. I run with it. In licks, yup, trying to get it. I think she said something like, well, that's just unnecessary. It usually is. Come with me, come with me. Last two. Cha cha. Tip it over. Brace. Find your plank. Take your time. We row. So for the most part, you think I'm like that. You about to get a glimpse of the fit I'm giving. From the flow, mate, when I hit the domain. Cause I ain't one of these two bougie bros. Always in the club, holding up the wall. You about to get a taste of the weight that we do it down here in the eight. Come on, four more. Four. Three. I just let it dance. Every time the beat drops. Perfect. Weight can come down. Weight is down. I'm just gonna keep rolling, I can just tell. You need a mini band, my love. And as always, if you don't have a mini band, you do the exact same thing without. The exact same thing without. Mid shin. If your mini band is really hard, I would suggest coming above the knee. That will make it easier. If it's really easy, you can go down to your ankles. I actually might go down to my ankles. Okay. We've got that strong plank. Alternate the legs up. Alternatively, in case you don't know, now you know. It's exactly the same. It's just less weight bearing because you've used the wall instead of the floor. Equally good, you do what you need to do. I will say this. I want you to push into something. So don't just do this standing without having a wall or a piece of furniture to press into, because I want that sense of planking. Shoulder girdle, front ribcage, belly. Three, two, one. So when I say that, you can totally do that here. We've done that before. Try it. You're not going to get that same sense of planking. That's important, okay? Take her off. Get your weights. Second set. Your brain's seen it. Fine tune it. Nice big stance. Front hip catching. I want that front glute on fire. Give it more, give it more. Let's go for four. Tip it forward. Brace, you got that planking sense. Pull. You're not just pulling the elbow back, you are pulling the elbow back, but you're also pulling the shoulder open. Shoulder blade toward the spine. Better than this reggae guy. I can do this every morning, every evening. Have you screaming straight back to sunrise. A little deeper, come on, front leg down. Three, two, bring it through center. Feet out wide. We're gonna slow this ish down right here. Down. So when I slow it down, it doesn't mean that you get more rest time at the top. I know all the tricks, even if I can't actually see you. It means that you have more time down here, more time through here. Yeah, so you get a little extra beat at the top to squeeze your booty, to pull your belly in, to prep. Feel it. So we can apply mindfulness to everything we do. To feeling every moment of this exercise. How we place ourselves. How we breathe in it. Noticing your response to it. How do you feel? Not just physically. How do you feel? Give me one more. Beautiful. We're on our second side for that lunge. Split stance squat with that nice strong swing. Let's go. Front hip catches you. Back hip controls up. Squeeze. There's a sense of pulling your feet toward each other the entire time. Last two, come on. Tip it over. Brace belly in. Front hip. Use it. Weight down. Mini band, my love. Same setup. So if you want to plank, you can plank on the ground, or you're not going to have a choice. You're planking on the ground, or if you want, you're planking against the wall, piece of furniture, something that gives you that planking. So plank isn't just this. Plank is this. Yeah? Whoopsie. My band rolled. Okay. We've got a lift. Out, lift, out. I'm not tapping on the out, it's strictly air. Beautiful, don't stop. So we started with a little side bend, don't stop please. The action, we're not doing a side bend here, but that action taking the leg out to the side, you're stabilizing with those side bending muscles. Feel it. So it's not just booty, side body. Two more on each side. Beautiful. All the way up, love. Slide that band up around your outer thighs. I need a little bit harder band. My band's just a wee bit easy. All right. Above the knees. We're standing. Over complications. Deadlift, shoulder press. Hinge. You have so much time. Soon, So I love all this kind of hang time here. It gives you an opportunity to squeeze your butt, to feel this end point, the action of stabilizing, and then keeping that stability the whole way up with the arms, yeah? Belly in. When I say belly in, I don't want it to be so extreme that you feel like you can't breathe. It's just a sense of drawing back. I like to think of like a sandwich board. My booty, my belly, squeezing toward the center line to keep me nice and strong. Nice and neutral. There's gonna be a certain amount of movement in the shoulders into the rib cage. That's normal. So as much as we're on lockdown, a little bit of freedom. What I'm looking for is not a huge arch in the back. So remember, we are working on basics. Deadlift. How do you curl those hands up to your shoulders? How do you press up overhead? Don't even think about stopping. There's an end in sight. Last two right here. Can't go away, girl, I'ma need you. Play your game like they might take it to an Ivy League school. Won't get Hall of Fame dick from minor league dude. I see pussy, other people need food. Only got a little time and I ain't trying to spend it. All you in about who ain't giving who attention. Squeeze your butt, squeeze your butt, squeeze your butt. Need to reboot. I see pussy, other people need food. Beautiful. Again, ignore those lyrics. Lordy, lordy, lordy. All right. I'm going lighter on the weights here. A little lighter on the weights. Movement's not big. Why? Because we're banded. That's the main reason. Weights at your... Weights at your side. Sorry. Out to the side. Side raise. Out to the side. My band is going to roll up. I don't know about your band. I'm gonna try to control it. So it's like a little tiny mini side lunge. It is so much less about how far you go out, so much more about the intention of pushing out from that leg, right here, pushing out, catching in the hip, and then nice and strong to take those arms out to the side. You've got it. And then you know this. I'm gonna say it, but you know it. Most of the stuff I'm saying, you already know. I'm just giving you reminders. Your weight is balanced in your feet. You're on your center. You're fine-tuning every single movement. Yes. My band is rolling down. It's going to be like a tourniquet soon. It's going to be like a millimeter thick and just digging in. But you know what? By then we're going to be done. That's the good news. So you better hope it happens soon. Or I'll call one more on each side. Last one. Beautiful. Put the weights down. Take your mini band off, please. You're going to have a seat. You're going to have a seat. Sideline. Oblique. Side bending muscles, crossing muscles, all those we're going to look for. Knees are up. Maybe it's a little just right here. Maybe just holding up is enough for you. It can even help out your legs. If it's okay, I'm gonna kick it out. So it's almost like you're bringing your bottom shoulder toward the knees and you're shortening on this side. You can put this elbow up and kind of press into the hand. Totally fine. Not just fine, it's fantastic. Fan-friggin-tastic. One more. Beautiful. Set it up. There's no rush. Set it up. Sometimes just the setup is enough. You're feeling it already? Perfect. You stay here. Sometimes movement makes it a little easier. Yes. Yes. So good. Two more. I lied. Two more after this one. Two more. That feels more like the right amount. Beautiful. We've got push-ups. And like I said, we're working basics. Push-ups are a basic. If they're hard for you, use your knees. You don't have to suffer. You're not proving anything to anybody except yourself. So execute them like a friggin' pro, or just kind of hold your plank. Try not to just like waffle your way, worm through them. Sometimes you gotta do that to find the range of motion. Here's what I'm gonna say. Hands, arms like this. Not like this, like this. You see the difference there? Hug, without hugging the elbows in, hug them in. You're engaging your lats. A little bit like your thumbs are pulling toward each other. The whole time. Set it up. Let's go. Drop, lift. Belly strong. Legs strong. Squeeze your butts. Feel the movement of the shoulder blades on your back. Two more. Beautiful. Knees down. All the way up. I'm telling you, this position of the arms, it feels weird because your chest is a little more forward. That action of the hands and the engagement of your lats, it will make it easier. Sometimes I'm not fully present and I'm like, why are these so stinking hard? And then it's like, I have to recheck myself. I'm like, oh, I got this. Mini band. Mini band. Above the knees. Deadlift. Curl to shoulder press. Just like you did last time. Just like last time, you have so much time. I don't know if my house is hot today, if it's because I'm wearing a long sleeve shirt, but I'm sweating so much over here. We haven't jumped around at all. We haven't done one single plyometric yet. Did you notice that? We technically haven't even done anything that's cardio-based, right? I hope you're sweating with me. Let me go check the temperature on the thermostat. Every moment matters. Every movement matters. Every bit of stability matters. Being here doing this, this is a gift. To move our bodies like this, this is a gift. When I was pregnant, was just thinking about this on Sunday because I was at the Culver City Stairs. I'm a big Santa Monica Stairs girl. Not lately, but we were at the stairs and Cade was just blasting up the stairs. And I used to do the stairs with him in my belly. And I think that that's why, but that's not the point of my story. When I did them with him in my belly, you got a couple more. When I was getting bigger at one point, I was like, God, I'm so dedicated. What a warrior I am. Everyone around me must be in amazement by me. Maybe not quite that far. I didn't take it that far. But right when I was feeling like so like proud of myself, which it's fine, I should have. Some guy with one leg goes blasting past me on the stairs. One leg. We got no excuses, y'all. And it's a blessing to be doing this. This is your last one. So good. Keep the band. Lighten your weights up. Or not. I don't know what you were using. Maybe it's the same weight. I'm going to try to take my tourniquet and minimize the, kind of mitigate the situation, minimize the odds of it happening. Let's do this. Little mini side lunge. It's more about going back and that pushing out, that stabilization. Now, can you send your hip back when the foot lands and keep your whole foot flat, toes down? I'm sure I've already told you that stairs story, by the way. Sorry if you already heard it. It's someone's first time. And then I actually said, well, he has two crutches. So technically, he has three legs. Kidding. I'm totally kidding. He was amazing. He was so motivational. And then I started thinking to myself, I'd be home watching soap operas. Also not true. And then I actually thought, that's not true. I might not have been on the stairs, but I would have been doing something. Mark my words. If that happens, I'll be doing something. I'll be finding him to train me. Knock on a whole lot of wood right now. It's all a blessing. This life is a blessing. Don't stop. I am not tourniquet yet. I'm good. Still here for like 10 more minutes. Yes. This is your last one. Put him down. Okay. We'll be down. Out, out, in, up. Out, out, in, up. Perfect, switch it. The reason the basics are so important, not that this is basic, the reason I'm saying it right now, is that when you have the basics down, when you're able to hold yourself in certain positions with some sense of efficiency, proficiency, you can start to add some more kind of tricks and doozies in there. But if you're not starting from a good foundation, it's already gonna be like three times as hard as it needs to be hurt then. If your foundation is super strong. Yeah. One more. Perfect. Push-ups. You know I love push-ups. I mean, I don't love them, but I love them for what they accomplish. Same thing. We're gonna do a knee in between. So push-up, knee comes in like you're gonna do a half a mountain climber, but it's slow. When that knee comes in, you hollow the belly, you get a nice roundness in the back. When you go back to your plank for push-up, you keep a tiny bit of that. If you're not sure, watch me first. Let's go. Beautiful. You've got triceps. Flip onto your backs. We're gonna take a bridge with our triceps. So, weights are up. Lift your hips up. Drop your hips 2 inches. Shorten from your belly button to your pubic bone. Squeeze your butt, lift back up. I want that the whole time. Squeeze your booty. Elbows bend. Down. Back up. It's slow. Again, not so that you have rest time on the top, so that you can fully execute. And feel every inch of that movement. You've got this. Check in with your butt, check in with your butt. Whole foot presses down. You can move your feet wherever you need to so that you feel whole foot pressing down, glutes active, and supporting you up. Check in with your butt, come on, squeeze. Let's go. Come on. One more. Beautiful. Weights come down. Hands to the sky. I truly believe this is easier with weight. We're going to do the first set without any weight. Inhale. Exhale. Hollow the belly. Reach for your knees, little pause, and then bring it back down with the inhale. Exhale. Not as high as you can go, just to the knees, and back down. I am such a dork. You know this by now. I am tapping my knees. Every single time I come up, you don't have to. It gives me a sense of where I am in space. Keeping that range of motion. Feet are pressing down, glutes are awake. Last two. One more. Beautiful. You've got a side plank on your forearm, please. Side plank on your forearm. Top leg is going to come in front of the bottom leg. You can also bend your bottom leg and put your foot behind you and use your bottom knee. Top leg is in front. You're going to keep the hip pointing forward. Elbow starts a little closer to your hip than directly under your shoulder, because then when you come up, your elbow will be right under your shoulder. You're here. We're just holding. Basic strong. Push down into this forearm. Spread your collarbone. Spread your shoulder blades. Legs strong. Feet pushing down. Push the ground away with that forearm, elbow. Lock that shoulder in place. Shoulder blade into the back. Baby. Hold four, three, two, release it. So good. Second side. Top leg is in front. Bring the elbow a little closer to your hip than you think. So if you look down, it looks like your shoulder's a little bit past the elbow. That way, when you lift up, you're pretty much stacked. You can adjust it if you need to. I am telling you, I would rather move in a side plank any day of the week than just hold it. But this is our foundational pose. This is our foundational exercise that gives us good form to then add to it. We get really caught up in wanting to do all the fancy tricks. Sometimes you have to revisit the basics. Often. Squeeze your butt. Check in with his forearm. Check in with his bottom shoulder. Beautiful. Sit down. We're back to triceps with that bridge. Push your feet down. Try taking your feet a little wider than your hips, turning your toes slightly open. Push your feet down, lift your hips up, drop a half an inch. Scoop the belly button to pubic bone. Push the feet down, squeeze the glutes. Let's go. Bend, lift. It's fast. If it's too fast, slow it down. I don't care if you're on beat with the music. And I say this a lot, but it's important to move at different tempos. We need to learn how to produce power, speed. Oh my God, last two. Woo, one more. Oh my gosh. I might have been a little overzealous with the 15s there. All right, feet are down. With or without the weight, it's your call. Just to the knees, just to the knees. Inhale to prepare. Push your feet down. Exhale, bring it up. Now you tell me in your head, you tell yourself which one is easier, with or without the weight. I truly believe without the weight is harder. This gives you a driver, gives you something to push into. So while we're weighting the body, it kind of assists you in a way because you've got something to push against. Yes, yes, yes. You are killing it. Don't stop yet. Weight comes all the way down. Side plank. Gonna add a little movement because you earned it. Take it down. Now lift up nice and high. Don't just focus on the down. Feel that lift. Push into the arm. Three. Two. Beautiful. Bring it around. Exact same setup. Top leg is in front. Bottom knee still works. Bring it up. Make sure your foundation's good. Drop. Lift. Last one. Come through center, knees down. Stretch it back. You're amazing. Left foot forward. Squeeze the right hip. Lift the right arm up. Bring it back down. Take it back. Right foot comes forward. Squeeze that left glute. Left arm comes up. Bring both hands down. Step it back. Down dog. Hands and feet walk together, please. And one knee, straighten the other leg. Drop the head. Switch it.
but I'm staying, I suppose, cause I don't know how I'm getting home.
Bend both knees, roll up your spine. Big inhale on the top. Exhale, bring it through center. You are done. Good work.